Hey everyone, this is another LACO Fact Check. It is a common refrain from former members of the South Florida Water Management District that it wasn't the discharges out of Lake Okeechobee that caused algal blooms, but it was our own local water runoff. Now it's absolutely true that we do have our own local pollution issues that need to be solved, but it's stubborn and it's wrong to deny the fact that discharges coming out of Lake Okeechobee contained freshwater algal blooms in them, that in the summer of 2018, Lake Okeechobee was 90% covered in algal blooms at one point. Those waters were released into our coastal saltwater estuaries. And the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers' own study conducted with the U.S. Geological Survey and the Department of Interior, they found that as freshwater cyanobacteria are transported to brackish and saltwater, that there will be a loss of membrane integrity, which leads to the release of cellular microcystin into the surrounding water body. What that's saying is when those freshwater algal blooms are released into salt water, that's when the toxins are released. So it is, according to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers' own research, the Army Corps' decision to transfer algal blooms from freshwater Lake Okeechobee into our saltwater estuary that causes the toxins to be released into our estuary, into our community, threatening our health, our safety, those of us around our saltwater treasure coast. And as we all know, these toxins tested nearly 50 times too toxic for human contact last summer. Lower lake levels at the beginning of the wet season would reduce the need to make these discharges and help prevent these toxic releases. This public health crisis is preventable with zero discharges, and that is a Lake O Fact Check.